الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبعد. Indeed, ya akhwan wa akhawat, we benefit from the reminders found in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And from those reminders, ya akhwan, is that which concerns us regarding our lives and ultimately, ya akhwan, our demise. As the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, لو كان لابن آدم واديا من ذهب لا أحب أن يكون له واديان ولا يملأ فاه إلا التراب ومن تاب تاب الله عليه. In this authentic narration, ya Ikhwan, there are a number of benefits that we must take and we must reflect upon for our own lives, and as we have said, Ikhwan, for our own demise. For that ultimate meeting, ya Ikhwan, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Messenger of Allah said, ya Ikhwan, in the translation, if one of the sons of Adam, one of the children of Adam, had a whole valley of gold, then they would desire and hope for two valleys of gold. And nothing will fill the mouth of the sons and daughters of Adam except dirt. And if those people repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely, then Allah will forgive them. In this narration, Ikhwan, there are a number of benefits that we must pay attention to and that we must take. Firstly, Ikhwan, that all of us, the sons and daughters of Adam, are in a constant, Ikhwan, reaching and striving for the affairs of the worldly life. So much so, no matter what we are blessed with, no matter what we have from wealth and from children and from finance and from cars and from homes, it's never enough. We are constantly chasing after the dunya, wearing ourselves out from the early morning until the late evenings, wearing ourselves out, striving and chasing after the worldly lives, ya Ikhwan. Until the Messenger of Allah Muhammad has informed us that if one of us had a whole valley of gold, multi-billionaire, multi-millionaire, that their days are still filled with chasing after the worldly matters. And there was nothing, Ikhwan, that filled the mouths of the sons and daughters of Adam except dirt. The noble scholar Sheikh Al-Albani has explained this narration in his checking of the Riyad al-Saliheen of Imam al-Nawawi, where he mentions, Ikhwan, that the meaning of this is that the only thing that will stop your appetite, the only thing that will stop your chasing after the worldly life, is when you die. And when we begin to put that dirt over your grave, that's the only thing, Ikhwan, that will fill your belly, that will fill your mouth, that will fill your appetite, is when death overtakes you. We find in the authentic narration, ya Ikhwan, of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ya Ikhwan, this tremendous statement. And that which is backed up in the ayah of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعَ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهِ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Furqan, ya Ikhwan, and on that day, on the day of resurrection, when no wealth or no children will avail you, only those who come to Allah with a pure heart. It doesn't matter what you have gathered together, Ikhwan, from wealth. It doesn't matter what you have gathered together from gold. It doesn't matter what you have piled up from homes and cars. The only thing that will benefit you on that day, as Allah says, إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهِ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. The only thing that will benefit you on that day, on the day of resurrection, are those who come to Allah with a pure heart. So as we see in that first narration, that nothing will satisfy the appetites of the children of Adam except when the dirt comes upon them. وَمَنْ تَابَ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَابَ اللَّهِ يَنِي عَلَيْهِ. That whoever repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah will forgive them. So what is important for us, Ikhwan, as we mentioned in that first narration, is tawbah ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's seeking Allah's forgiveness, not the piling up of wealth, not trying to get that other valley of gold, but rather, Ikhwan, returning to Allah in repentance. Because no one, Ikhwan, who comes to Allah with wealth or children will be availed on Yawm al-Qiyamah. You will only be availed, Ikhwan, those who come to Allah with a pure heart. What do we find in the authentic narration of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he said, Ya Ikhwan, yatba al-mar'u ila qabrihi thalatha. Three things will follow a man to his grave. Three things will follow a woman to her grave. Ma'lahu wa ahlahu wa amalahu. Your wealth, your property, your wealth is the first thing. And your family, and then your deeds. Yarja ithnani wa yabqa wahid. Two of them are going to return, the Messenger of Allah Muhammad said, and only one will remain with you. Yarja ma'lahu wa ahlahu. Ask for that which is going to return. Then the Messenger of Allah Muhammad said, your wealth and your family is coming back to this worldly life. You can't take it with you, Ya Ikhwan. So we follow the funeral procession. We follow our brothers and our sisters into the graveyard. We place them in the ground. And we pour the dirt over them either by shovel, by hands, a handful. But know for certainty, Ikhwan, that when we begin to place that dirt, and when we finish, Ikhwan, and we walk back to our vehicles, and we travel from that graveyard, that which remains with the individual in his grave is one thing. يَبْقَى وَاحِدْ وَهُوَ عَمَلَهُ. That only one of those things will remain, it is your deeds. So now, Ikhwan, when we get in our cars after Yawm al-Jumu'ah, with our wives, we get into that which we have from our automobiles, that we purchase from the wealth, that we go back to the homes that we have bought with our money. Know for certainty right now, Ya Ikhwan, that the only thing that is going to remain with you in that grave are your actions and your deeds. As for that wife you are going to travel home with, as for those children sitting in the back of the car, as for the home you are traveling to, none of it is going with you. Not one dime of it. Not one knob of it. Not one steering wheel of it. Nothing is going to remain with you in the grave. The only thing that's going to remain with you are your actions and your deeds. What are you taking with you, Ya Ikhwan? What are you taking with you from your actions? What are you taking with you, Ikhwan, from salah? From prayer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What are you taking with you from zakat? From charity? What are you taking with you from a kind word? What are you taking with you from a kalima tayyibah? From a dhikr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What are you taking with you, Ikhwan, in your graves? Know for certainty, Ikhwan, that whatever you are piling up from wealth, and from homes, and from children, Allah has already said to us in the Quran, يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون. On the day when no children or wealth will avail you, it will be of no benefit, Ikhwan. إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. Except those who come to Allah with a pure heart. Know, Ya Ikhwan, that all of us are going to have an ultimate meeting of death, and that none of us can escape it. It is an ultimate affair, Ya Ikhwan. It is the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we must prepare ourselves, Ikhwan, for that day. Someone came to the Messenger of Allah Muhammad and they said, Mata yawm al-qiyamah? When is the day of judgment? And the Messenger of Allah Muhammad said, and what have you prepared for it? What have you put forward for it, Ya Ikhwan? What are you doing from your deeds and your actions? Do we not find in the Quran where Allah says, وَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّهُ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. Allah says in the Quran, Ya Ikhwan, and Adam, he learned words of repentance from his Lord, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he repented to Allah, and Allah forgave him. Indeed, Allah is the all-forgiving, most merciful. As we saw in that first narration, Ya Ikhwan, من تاب تاب الله عليه. Whoever repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah forgives them. While we're chasing after that valley of gold that is of no avail to us. While we're trying to increase ourselves in women and children. While we're trying to increase ourselves in clothes and things to brag about and boast about. Know that this whole dunya, Ikhwan, as Allah says, of boasting and bragging and piling up of wealth and of things, Ya Ikhwan. But Noah, the Messenger of Allah Muhammad said, "Kull ad-dunya mal'oon illa dhikr Allah." The whole of the dunya is cursed except the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of these worldly things are finite, ya ikhwan. They mold away. Bread turns to mold. The metals, they rust, ya ikhwan. The cars, they rust. The clothes, they tatter, they turn to stitches. The bones, they break, ya ikhwan. Know for certainty they will be of no avail to you in your grave. You can no longer eat from them. You can no longer drink from them. You can no longer enjoy those wives. You can no longer throw those children on your shoulders. Know for certainty, ya ikhwan, that it is all going to flee from you and leave from you. The only thing that will remain with you, ikhwan, are your deeds and your actions. Put them forward, ya ikhwan. Put them first in your lives. And understand what we find in the end of this narration. Man taba taba Allah alayhi. Don't concern yourself with the piling up of wealth and the piling up of children and the piling up of the fancy things of this worldly life. Concern yourself with action from them tawba to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Messenger of Allah Muhammad says in the authentic narration, لِلَّهِ أَشَّدُّ فَرِحًا بِتَوْبَةَ عَبْدِهِ مِنْ مَرْءُ فِي أَرْضٍ دَوِيَةٍ مُهْلِكَةٍ. That Allah is more happy. Allah is happy, ikhwan, with the repentance of his slave than the one who was in a desolate land, than the man who was traveling in a desolate land. مَعْهُ رَاحِلَتُهُ وَعَلَيْهَا طَعَامُهُ وَشَرَابَهُ. Who has with him, ikhwan, his riding animal, and upon it is all of his provisions, his food and his drink. But he falls asleep between a tree, beneath a tree. And when he wakes, ya ikhwan, he finds that animal has fled from him. He can no longer find that animal, ya ikhwan. Upon it, ikhwan, are his food and his drink. And that he believes, ikhwan, that he will die, as he has no means of provisions. And he lays down beneath that tree, ikhwan, waiting till death overtakes him. But when he wakes after sleeping, he finds that animal with his provisions, his drink and his food upon it, ya ikhwan. And then he says, because of how happy he is, Ya Rab, Anta Abdi wa Ana Rabbuk. He says to Allah, O Allah, you are my slave and I am your Lord. The Messenger of Allah Muhammad said, Akhda min shiddat al-farah. He made a mistake because of how happy he was. He was so happy he didn't even know what he was saying. Lillahi ashaddu farahan bi tawbati abdihi min hadha. And the Messenger of Allah Muhammad ends the narration by saying, indeed Allah is happier, ikhwan, with the repentance of his slave than this man who was found his riding animal in that desolate land. Repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya ikhwan. Make tawbah to Allah from every sin. Come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't concern yourself with wealth. Don't concern yourself with piling up children. Don't concern yourself with the cars and the fancy things of this worldly life. For certainly, ikhwan, death is going to come to all of us. And it will be nothing but that which is left to be divided. To be divided up between our spouses, between our children. Debts that we have accumulated. Know for certainty, ikhwan, that what concerns us is tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tamassuk bis-sunnah. Clinging firmly to the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For we can now talk about what a man has left from food and from drink, and what he has left from children and from wives and from cars and from homes. But know for certainty, ikhwan, what we celebrate is a man tamassuk bis-sunnah. A man clinging firmly to the sunnah. A man, ikhwan, calling to the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and clinging firmly to that and repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That was what is going to avail us on Yawm al-Qiyamah. That is what, ikhwan, is going to be a protection for us from the fire, a shield for us from the fire on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Not as we see in the ayah, not wealth and not children, but rather those who come to Allah with a pure heart. And the second part of this khutbah, ikhwan, we will further examine the importance of tawbah and the absence of concern with the affairs of the worldly life. Alhamdulillah. والصلاة والسلام رسول الله يما بعد. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran, يا إخوان, يا أيها الذين آمنوا توبوا إلى الله توبة نصوحة عسى ربكم أن يكفر عنكم سيئاتكم ويدخلكم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his Quran, O you who believe, repent to Allah a sincere repentance, that perhaps your Lord would expiate your sins and enter into paradise beneath which rivers flow. This ayah, Ikhwan, from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a reminder for all of us. And Allah is addressing those who believe, O you who believe. Tubu ila Allahi tawbatan nasuha. Repent to Allah sincerely, O Ikhwan, before the time comes. Before death approaches us. Before the soul is gargled in the throat. Return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our sins, for our transgressions. No matter how much we have done in opposition and contradiction to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Man taba ila Allah, taba Allah alayhi. Whoever repents to Allah, ya akhwan, Allah will forgive them. La taqnutu min rahmatillah, inna la yaghfiru dhunuba jami'a. Do not lose hope in the mercy of Allah. Allah forgives all sins. Oh, you who believe, ikhwan, as Allah says, repent to Allah sincerely. Do not be from those who shaitan is fooled and he has deceived and he has deluded into believing that which you have done, that you cannot repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not listen to the people, ikhwan, who blame you and who point at you and who speak about you. Know that Allah forgives all sins. And Allah is Tawwab al-Rahim. That Allah is all-forgiving, most merciful. Repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Throw out the affairs of the worldly life. Leave out the affairs of the dunya. Leave out the affairs of chasing after the worldly affairs that lead to transgression, that lead to sin, that lead to opposition to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But rather, ikhwan, turn to Allah. Turn to Allah in repentance. Turn to Allah as the companions of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad wasallam did. Look at the narration, ikhwan, of Ma'az ibn Malik, who committed the act of adultery. And he came to the Messenger of Allah Muhammad wasallam and he said, Tahirni ya Rasulullah, purify me, O Messenger of Allah. And the Messenger of Allah Muhammad wasallam turned and a'radha anhu, turned away from him. And Ma'az turned and he walked towards the face of the Messenger of Allah Muhammad wasallam as the Prophet wasallam turned his body from Ma'az ibn Malik. And Ma'az followed the Messenger of Allah Muhammad wasallam. Tahirni ya Rasulullah, purify me, O Messenger of Allah. And the Messenger of Allah Muhammad a'radha anhu, turned away from him again. But Ma'az continued to follow up the Messenger of Allah Muhammad wasallam. Tahirni. Utahiruka min madha. And what am I purifying you from? And in one narration it said, Ya Akhwan, wayhaka, waylaka, tubila rabbik. In another wording it says, woe to you, go and repent to your Lord. But Ma'az continued, Tahirni ya Rasulullah, purify me, O Messenger of Allah. He wanted, as the ulama have mentioned, Ikhwan, as we find in that ayah, Tawbah Nasuha, sincere repentance. Allah says, O you who believe, repent to Allah sincerely. Tawbah Nasuha, ya Ikhwan. So Ma'az wanted this Tawbah Nasuha, ya Ikhwan. But the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad wasallam, said, Hal bihi junoon. Does he have his faculties? Does he have his mental faculties? Asking the other from his companions, from his friends, from his neighbors, from his kinfolk. And this is indeed he does. And the Messenger of Muhammad commanded someone to smell him to make sure he wasn't intoxicated. And after all of this, the Messenger of Muhammad said, perhaps you only kissed her. Perhaps you only fondled her. Trying to give Ma'az a way out, ya Akhwan. But Ma'az said, La, ya Rasulullah, no. But rather have done that which is obligating the punishment. So after this, the Messenger of Allah Muhammad wasallam, ya Akhwan, had that ditch be dug. And Ma'az was placed in that ditch. And he was stoned to death. And there mentioned in the narration, Akhwan, that one of the stones hit him. And the blood came on the foe of one of the people. And they cursed him. And the Messenger of Allah Muhammad wasallam said, do not curse him. For indeed, he has brought a repentance that if it was divided upon a whole ummah, لَكَفَتْهُمْ, it would be sufficient for them. Ma'az ibn Malik, Ikhwan, desired tawbah even over life. He desired repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even over going on living, ya Ikhwan. He sacrificed himself, ya Ikhwan, in repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the narration of Al-Ghamidiyya, ya Ikhwan, the woman who came to the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a similar circumstance. And when she was stoned, it mentions the narration that Umar al-Khattab said, Will you pray upon her, ya Rasulullah, wa lakad zanat, and she has committed fornication. And the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, indeed she has brought a tawbah, that if it was disseminated amongst the whole nation, amongst all of the people of Medina, lakafatum, it would have been sufficient for them. So here we see Al-Ghamidiyya, here we see Ma'ad ibn Malik, these noble companions, ya Ikhwan. They preferred tawbah, they preferred sincere repentance, even over life. Let us stop chasing after the worldly affairs. Let us stop chasing after the dunya. Let us stop chasing after these piling up of women and children and wealth. Let us make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us recognize, ya Ikhwan wa akhawat, O brothers and sisters, that all of us are going to face that ultimate meeting. And some of us, Ikhwan, we go to the gravesite and we bury our brothers and our sisters. We wash them and we shroud them, and we carry them in our vehicles to the gravesites, and we take them and we place them in the earth, and we place them in the niche, and we do all of these things. And then we come back from the gravesite and we go back to the chasing after the dunya. We go back to chasing after the worldly life. We require sometimes become heedless of the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right after we leave the graveyards. How soon are we joking and laughing and playing? How soon after that reminder? But as the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ya Ikhwan, if you knew what I knew, you would laugh less and you would cry more. If you knew what I knew, what the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you would laugh less and you would cry more. And that is why the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ كَثْرَةُ الضَّحَكُ تُمِيتَ الْقَلْبِ. Indeed, an abundance of laughing kills the heart. Remember, ya Ikhwan, the meeting with Allah. Remember, ya Ikhwan, that ultimate affair of death that is going to come to all of us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Ikhwan,